guys. Good afternoon. Hope you had a good lunch, and happy to be here, of course. The support of the online community has always been very helpful to the project I'm involved with, and it doesn't stop. And thank you for the support here for Hele. Happy to be here, guys.
Okay, so as we all know, Hele is showing on March 26th nationwide, and every day po, dumadami yung sinihan na magpapalabas. As of yesterday, Miss AC, ano ba? Hindi, 25 na. Okay, sige, later on we'll update that list. Okay, would like to, the question answer is now open. Who would like to ask the first question? Siguro si Joyce. Ayan, can we have a mic for Joyce or Philstar? Ayan, that mic in the center, please.
Ay, hello, sir. Kasi nabanggit po kahapon ni Direk Love na parang sabi niya, nung present niya sa inyo, parang yung film, parang after one look, parang, sige, game. So parang, what made you say yes immediately introducing this character?
I think offhand, the main reason, the number one reason I produced this film is because I simply just wanted to learn from the great Lav Diaz. As a student of film, as a very young filmmaker myself, I was always, you know, encouraged to learn from those who have come before me, who have kind of, you know, paved the way for Philippine cinema. And there was just an opportunity to work with Lav, and I may not have been an expert on Lav Diaz cinema, but I was familiar with his cinema, and it was very unique. Instantly, you were gravitated towards the length. But what I really admired about Lav Diaz is that he tells films, he expresses his films the way he wants to, and he's not going to let anyone tell him how or how to tell his stories. So that was just an opportunity. It was just a great opportunity for me to learn from the great Lav Diaz, just to pick his brain, what how's his creative process, what makes him tell stories the way he tells stories. And all I can say is for the last 2 years working closely with him, it's been, I think, one of the most wonderful experiences of my life. Something that can't be taught anywhere else, but only on his sets, only in his meetings. And it has made me a better person, a better filmmaker at that. I can take my learnings from producing Hele to the next films I'll be doing. And yeah, I mean, that's pretty much the main reason. And of course, after I said yes, you know, I'm also the type of a producer that likes to take risks. You know, I kind of thrive on the uncertainty of things. It was just also such a beautiful screenplay. I first read the 1997 version or 1998 version, because he wrote this film 17 years ago, and that's the script I read that was given to me, and just beautiful words. I think Lav is a poet in a way, you know. He just has a way of telling his stories, like everything you need to know about direction, about what he wants is on the paper. And it was just a mesmerizing, really took me out of my element when I read the screenplay. And it evolved, because the screenplay, Lav continued to rewrite it and that's kind of his creative process. He writes as the film is being made. He likes to write on location, he likes to write on the day of the shoot. So as a producer, you have to be really on your toes always. You have to expect the unexpected, but it just made working with him so much fun. Very challenging, but you know, any film that you make is challenging, so we knew that coming in. But you know, yeah, I think for me, most importantly, you know, as a student of film, I got firsthand front row seats to a Lav Diaz masterclass, and I've learned so much.
Very good, Joyce. Go ahead.
Kasi parang, you know, na parang the viewers kasi will not use sa ganitong kahabang film. So, do you think parang the audience will be ready for this? Or is this a good start for them to?
Well, yes, I think anytime you want to create, I don't want to say, and I don't think anybody could change Philippine cinema. Philippine cinema is what the Filipino filmmakers want it to be. You know? We just want to contribute to it. You cannot create change overnight. Lav Diaz has been making films for as long as I can remember. I mean, when he was writing the screenplay in 97, I was still in high school. So he's been making films for a long, long time. And it's really only now he's getting, I heard, 20-plus cinemas. You know, I mean, he told me he's used to cinemas where there's only one person watching his films, two people watching his films. And so he has evolved. But it's also taken time. You know? You have to be very patient in cinema. And I would like to think, yes, this is definitely a challenge for the common moviegoer to experience. It's literally going to take your whole day to watch the film. But I hope it's a start. It's a step in the right direction where we can actually now create an audience slowly. And hopefully 10 years from now, we can always look back on Hele, or what Hele started, and we can grow from there. You always have to plant seeds, naman. So, and together with Star Cinema, you know, the biggest distribution film company here in the Philippines, to take on also a project like this, this is definitely out of their norm. Definitely left field. It's also nice to know that, you know, giant studios, you know, respect and support art films and cinema. I mean, in general, just cinema.
Okay, thank you, Joyce. Thank you, Direk. A question now from Bernie Franco of Pep.ph.
Direk, so if I what? What do you think about, well, it's 8 hours, do you think the audience is ready? And what's your opinion on that? What are your expectations?
Well, I think it's tough to say if they're ready. We'll have to find out on March 26th now, when it shows. But I'll tell you this, there is an audience for this cinema, and we witnessed that in Berlin. Where over 1,600 to 2,000 people sold out our gala premiere night. And, you know, they were there. They watched every minute, every second of the film. And Lav was just, you know, applauded for his first efforts. We're so thankful to the Berlin Selection Committee for accepting the film the way it was. They never asked us to cut it, or they never asked us to alter it. They accepted it in competition. 8 hours, so it's proven to me that there is an audience for it. Now, is there an audience for it here? We'll find out on March 26th. And I'm hopeful. I'm also very optimistic, and I want to say that yes, the audience is ready. Only because it seems like everyone right now is looking for change. I mean, not just in cinema, but in our government. You know, in other branches of this country, like everyone's looking for a change with traffic. So people are looking for alternative things now. And with social media, it allows us also to reach those people. So I would like to think, and I believe in the Filipino. I believe that the Filipinos will support their own, will finally get introduced to the cinema of Lav Diaz. And hopefully, after they do watch Hele, they'll be interested in some of his past works. Because they're just all equally powerful in their own right. And at the end of the day, I'm just so happy that we have this opportunity and that, there are people supporting us. You know, you guys, ABS and the cinemas are supporting us. It's a special case. It's 8 hours, but it's a special case. So I urge and I challenge the people out there that to challenge their thinking and to kind of, fulfill their curiosity that, you know, okay, there's this 8-hour film. Okay, yes, it's long, but okay, it's Lav Diaz, a very celebrated filmmaker abroad. There was over 2,000 plus people in Berlin that were interested in a film about the Philippine Revolution. You know, why can't I, you know, my own history, why can't I be interested in that? And I hope that is the mentality they take when they go to the cinemas on the 26th of March and the days after. That they will prove to us, and they will prove to me and the whole Hele team, that the audience is ready for films like this, and that we can continue to tell stories like this so that we could be encouraged to make more.
Does it make you nervous that you're up against Batman, Superman?
That's right, yeah. I mean, it's I guess, for me, how I look at it, let's see how much the Filipino loves their own. I mean, we can look at it, we can make it a social experiment. You know, the Filipinos, at least the ones I've met and the ones I have experienced, are very proud of their home, where they come from, even though we are so challenged as a nation. But at the end of the day, despite all the hundreds of challenges we go through, everybody says there's nothing like the Philippines, there's nothing like home. So hopefully, when they have a choice on the 26th, Batman versus Superman or Hele, that they will prioritize also maybe the local culture and choose us. And of course, they can also watch. It's two different, two very contrasting films. So there's definitely no competition. I mean, you have popcorn on the Batman and Superman, and you hear you have, I think, something revolutionary in terms of learning about our history and educating ourselves on where we've been, so that we can continue to learn and move forward, hopefully ask the right questions, and like I said, challenge your thinking when you watch on Hele.
Thank you, Direk. Thank you, Bernie. And now a question from Melba.
Ayan. Kasi di ba you mentioned kanina na parang kinawa na yung first, yung 1997, 1998, may mga binago?
It definitely evolved. I think when you work with Lav, every day changes.
Okay.
But it changes, it gets better. It's not changes na parang he didn't like this, he didn't like that. He writes on the day, I appreciate that process, because his mind, for the whole time that we're shooting the film, his mind is in the film. You know, he's making things better, he's working on the dialogue, on the script. And once he puts those words on paper and gives it to his actors, that's pretty much, that's it. You need to say it verbatim, word for word, because it's just so poetic. There's no reason whatsoever to change his dialogue or to change his style. And as a producer, you want to create an environment for a director that can allow him to be as creative as possible. So, you know, of course we had a lot of limitations, but together with my co-producing partner, Bianca Balbuena, we had to try to create an environment where Lav could be at his best. And I'd like to thank the fact that we're here now, the fact that we did Berlin, is that we were able to do that, and Lav was able to tell the best story possible.
Direk, kasi pagkakaalam ko may mga movies before si Direk Lav Diaz, at makakaba nga, na in-edit pa para, minsan, 8 hours, sila mag 6 hours. Ito ba talagang 8 hours talaga, o may mga in-edit pa kayo ibang parts?
No, what you're gonna see on March 26 here is what the people in Berlin saw. It's exactly what, it's the same. The film that won in Berlin is the film that we will see here in the Philippines. And I know Lav, myself, we wanted to do that. Because we didn't want to shortchange the Filipino people. We wanted to show them, this is the film that won in Berlin. This is the film that Meryl Streep watched. This is the film that Clive Owen watched. So you're going to get to experience that. And so that they will know the kind of film that did their country proud over in Berlin.
Okay, Meryl, Melba, diba? So, you get to watch what Meryl saw. Direk, is Hele expensive?
You mean producing the film?
Producing the film.
You know, to be honest, it probably looks very expensive when you guys watch it on the
screen. Yeah,
it
looks.
But it's really a labor of love. Piolo, John Lloyd, pretty much just gave back their honorariums. They did it for love. They did it for love. The ensemble cast, the same thing. You know, it was. We told them, you know, this is all we have to offer, but this is the story. This is the vision of the director. Are you willing to join us in this, you know, revolution of sorts? And it wasn't at all as expensive as it may look, but it's expensive in terms of the heart that was put into the film, the passion that was put into the film, the after hours that was put into the film, the unsung heroes of the movie, you know, the gaffer, the utility, the sound designers. It's just, you know, it's priceless in that regard. And I guess we have this silver bear to show for it. So, exciting. And it's something I hope that the Filipino audience, ready or not, can appreciate that. And I really believe this, and I've been around the world, many different festivals, that the Filipino artist is the most talented person in the world. And I always say this is because we have such hardworking crews. Given the challenges and the situations, we still are able to pull through. our actors all over the Philippines are some of the most talented actors in the world because they're able to do multiple characters at the same time. They're able to sing and dance on the weekends. I mean, I don't see, you know, a George Clooney or Tom Cruise doing those things. They just do one project for 1 year. That's it. But you have Piolo, John Lloyd, who are juggling different characters, but not just portraying characters, but doing great work. And that goes for the rest of the cast as well. So, and I hope the Filipino audience can appreciate that and when they see this in the cinema, March 26th.
Incidentally, we have a special advanced screening. How do you say it? Ms. AC? Special screening on March 20th here at the Dolphy Theater. So, mawala pa tayo sa March 26th. So, may mga nag-ano ng vloggers.
Yeah, I'm sure that so they're invited.
Yeah,
right?
Yeah.
So you can
some of the production people
are give us your advanced reviews. Yeah, March 20th. We'll also all be there and we'll be in and out. I know we'll be doing some press stuff, but we'll be there and hopefully everyone does enjoy.
Okay, the next question will come from Trixie of glitcher.ph.
Hi. So you mentioned you like a lot of cinema, right? So what's your favorite Lav Diaz film, and what was the first Lav Diaz film you watched?
Well, I'll be honest, I've seen two of his films. I've seen Norte and Mula. I love Mula. It was it screened actually in Shangri-La. I think he had one cinema for that film. It was 6 hours. Actually, we watched it. I watched it with Direk Joyce, Piolo. We all went there on a Sunday, I think, and we watched it. And it was really my first time. So I saw Norte on a DVD, so I saw that at home. But it was my first time to be in a cinema for 6 hours and really just kind of getting lost in his images, in his storytelling. For those of you who haven't seen a Lav Diaz film, I always say it's like going to the museum. You're watching real life paintings just in front of you. You know, I like, especially when I'm abroad, to go to museums and to appreciate art, whether or not, whoever the artist is, it's just a nice sanctuary to be in. And that's kind of what the Cinema of Love is. It's a sanctuary where you can be moved, good, bad, you can be affected, good, bad, when you sit in that theater and experience the cinema. It's moving paintings, it's like there's not a single frame or composition that is just, everything was just correctly shot. And I think a lot of credit also goes to Larry Manda, the cinematographer, who worked very closely with Lav Diaz on shooting this film. It's just, Hele was just, when I first saw it, it was really one of those things like, only Lav Diaz can pull this off, you know? Like, walang iba, Lav Diaz lang. No? And so yeah, and so that's kind of my experiences with him.
Okay, just a bit of follow-up question. What were the challenges you encountered during, the shooting, including pre-production or post-production, and how many days did you actually get to shoot the film?
If I'm correct, I think it's about 22 to 24 days. We shot majority of the film in Sorsogon, Bulusan Lake, and just our surrounding areas, and it's one of the most beautiful places I've seen in the Philippines. Just one of the most original, untouched, virginal rainforests that our country has. And so we were there. We were isolated for literally almost about 2 to 3 weeks. The whole cast is there. So we actually became a little bit of a family in that end. So the working environment was just really perfect. Making this film was destiny, I say. It's just because, of course, with the big actors involved, to be able to get them, for 10, 12 days straight without interruption. That really helped them get into their characters. And their characters are very complex. Huh? These are not easy characters to portray. Well, of course, the usual challenges on the filmmaking set. Lav was just so cool and so calm. It was just, sometimes he wondered, like, are we okay? Is everything cool? But he just said, things are fine. I remember he was shooting a scene and then it started raining in the middle of the scene. So I thought, in the head, we're going to cut and retake. So I said, but he went on. I said, Direk, what happened? It rained, aren't you going to do it again? He goes, well, it rains in the world, diba? It rains in real life. He's very organic.
I know.
So, and for me, if there's a lesson, the lesson that I took from producing this film was, Lav taught me not to take life too seriously. Sometimes you just live it, keep calm, and you know, don't make it as such a big deal, and just don't take life too seriously, and have fun, you know? And you know, that really put a lot of things in perspective, because you know, as a filmmaker, I can be very meticulous, I can be very, you know, such a, you know, striving for perfection, but sometimes the best stories are told when it's just naturally unfolded there, and let God tell the story. And it's also very humbling. He's such a humble, nice guy, you know. It's like, you wouldn't think that this great storyteller is just also so humble and so genuine. So it made it really easy. So if ever the challenge is just very, very minimal, but like I said, it was destiny. This film was really destiny, because there's really no major problems.
Thank you.
Okay, thank you for that question. Here's another question from for you. Are you ready? Okay, a pretty girl from starstudio.ph.
Hey, pretty girl from
starstudio. Hi, it's nice meeting you. Congratulations for winning this Bear Award. Okay, my question is, what made you say yes to Direk Lav in producing this film?
Well, it was, besides the opportunity to work with him and to learn from him, it was the story. I elaborated earlier, I wanted to learn from him. That was really the main reason. And then, of course, the second came the story. You know, I was just so thankful that he had such a beautiful story, and that it was a story that spoke about our history. It spoke about a time when, you know, the Philippines was longing for answers. There was a lot of questions. There was a lot of searching going on. And to add, I guess, to that is, it's very timely also for today, because you know, we have elections coming up. There's a generation today longing for change. And what always puzzled me was that in 1890, during the revolution, we were asking questions. And in 2016, we're asking the same questions again. You know what, why can't we examine our history? Why can't we learn from it, truly learn from it, and actually apply it in the change that we want for today's generation? I mean, I want a great Philippines. This is my home. And that's the reason why every day, as citizens, we continue to fight for a better Philippines. We don't give up. And as a filmmaker, you know, I'm trying my best to contribute a little bit to that. It takes a collective effort, obviously. But, you know, if this film can ignite a revolution, you know, spark a change for the good in the youth today, it's also a great way for the youth today to learn about our history in a very visual, poetic way. And it's about time we start, you know, putting action to the things that we say. And I guess for me, my action was to produce this film, because in 1997, 1980, he was actually rejected, which is actually very funny, very ironic. Was Lav in 1998 got a grant from the government, from the NCAA, to produce the film. And they eventually backed out. They pulled back their grant. So I found it very ironic how our own government wouldn't support a film about art history. I mean, I just found it very ironic. It had to take, you know, a private citizen to do this. And so it's also another wake-up call for our government. And for me, as a filmmaker, I always ask these questions. Is, yes, I understand there's many problems in this country, but we should not and never forget art and cinema and theater and just the art of our country, because that's one of the greatest ways to express our culture, to express our voice as a nation, is through theater plays, through cinema, through television. You know, I'm very thankful to private companies, like, well, here, like ABS-CBN, I'm very supportive, but where's the government support? I'm not saying all government, there are some government officials that do support us. But in general, there's no incentives. It's hard. It's hard to make films in the Philippines. I mean, like, for example, you know, if when we arrived from Berlin, if I didn't provide a vehicle to pick up Lav, nobody, he would have just probably taken a taxi home. I mean, it's like, you know, Lav brought honor to this country, but there's just really no interest in that, you know. So that's kind of one of the things I hope that this film will awaken, that the government will support films on a more regular basis, you know, and give us more incentives to make more films like this. And hopefully Hele is a start to that.
My follow-up question po. But it's not related to the first one. So it's another question. So it took 2 to 3 weeks din po to shoot for the film in Sorsogon. Was there any separation anxiety with your with Tony?
No, wala. I mean, the beauty of our relationship is that we are both in cinema somehow. We're both in the industry, so there was none, of course. And with technology naman, it's easy. So, okay lang.
Kala ko naman kasi Tony. Kala ko separation anxiety with the cast. Kala ko yun
yun. Kala
ko yun.
Si Jane, sinabi ko ba naman pwede ka? Direk, can you may kwento about the... How did you learn about Hele being an entry to the Berlinale?
Well, I mean, I have to give it to Bianca Balbuena, also my producing partner in the film. You know, this girl has mastered the art of film festivals abroad. She just is the master at it, and honestly, I just have to ask her, right? Lav Diaz already has a brand abroad. He is, anything he does is already on the radars of the festivals. Especially, I think, Cannes. He's been to Cannes, Venice, and Berlin. He's been to all three already. I know in Berlin he's been in the forum section. This is his first time to be in the competition section. So, Lav Diaz has this stigma now. When he makes a film, you have a lot of festival programmers abroad already. Can I see? So, to be honest, we were actually, a lot of festivals were asking for the film. When was it done? But of course, we were at the mercy of Lav, who was also cutting the film. And now finally, I think after five, six months, he finished the film editing, and it just so happened that Berlin was around the same submission, so we submitted to Berlin, and Bianca was the one who organized that, and then yeah, I think it was really before Christmas, we got a letter from the festival director saying that they've accepted the film in competition, and that was, and they're accepting the film in its entirety, the full 8 hours, and you have to understand, the Berlin selection committee, they saw the rough cut. It was the rough cut. Wala pang, there was no voiceovers yet. Wala pang, because they wanted to see it. They wanted to see the whole film already. So they said, just send us what you have. So I guess that's just the power of a Lav Diaz film. So yeah, it was we couldn't announce anything until Berlin made the official announcements. But once Berlin announced, we were able to now share it with all our Filipinos. You know, and it was great because we were in the competition section, so I feel so spoiled because it's my first time to the Berlin Festival, and we, you know, competition right away. You know? So I just have to thank Lav for that, of course. And yeah, it was just a beautiful experience.
The funding of everyone, transportation, the accommodation.
Well, I mean, yeah, I mean, not to
personal.
Yeah. Well, no, actually, I had spent a lot of my resources already on making the film.
Oh my goodness.
I needed to go back to making more commercials so I could make more films. That's kind of how it works with me. Well, of course, you know, when you get into the festival, like Berlin in competition, we had to raise some funds. Right? So we kind of put together, we needed to raise, I think, about 1.2, 1.5 million. So we asked some of the publications to help us, you know, with this plea. And, you know, a lot of support from the government. Of course, the FDCP gave. The NCAA gave. I'm very thankful to politicians that gracefully gave. And to be honest, they never asked for any recognition. As a matter of fact, maybe this is the first time I'm actually going to say it, but Mayor Herbert Bautista was...
Well, he's a film on another
industry. We did a courtesy visit to his office, and he instantly made a way and gave us budget.
Okay.
And after that, we still needed a little bit more.
Okay.
He wasn't able to give the whole, but it was a big amount to help. So we wrote letters to several politicians. And Vice Mayor Isko Moreno was one who answered our call.
Oh.
And it was literally, he texted, he said, can you meet? I'm in QC. It was like around 10 p.m. I said, okay, I met. And then he said, how much more do you need? So we told him how much more we need, and he said, sige, sagot ko yan. So, So Mayor Herbert and Vice Mayor, so we're very thankful, and they didn't ask for any of this. I'm so sorry, boy, if I exposed you guys, but you have great hearts, and it's nice to know that the politicians who were in the industry, are still in the industry today, don't forget where they came from, and kahit paano, they still support films in their own little way. So we're very thankful. And of course, Star Cinema, we're in negotiations for the Philippine rights, and they took it on. So their contribution greatly also helped us with some other expenses that we had to pay for. We still had some, I don't want to say utang, but we still had to pay some post-production fees. So when ABS purchased the local rights, we were able to cover that and more. So when we were able to, and me personally, I was able to give some more fees to some of the people that really helped us behind the scenes. You know, it's a lot of people did this, like I said earlier, you know, for the passion, for very, just enough maybe to feed them for a day. But, you know, for me, I'm also the type to be able to give back where, you know, where credit is due. And so I told them, you know, and I'm urging the Filipino people, you know, the if you could do come support this film, you know, the for me, it's not, yes, you know, it's always great to make money, but it's also great to make money so that we can make more films like this. And so hopefully they all do support it.
Yes, that. Okay, we're down to our last three questions. The first being is with para yung kay Jude. Hi, Jude. Hey, Jude.
Hello, good afternoon, Direk. Piolo kasi mentioned he learned so much about Simeon. Simon.
Simon.
Simon naman ako. Simon. Kasi mas nakilala niya si Ibarra. Here, anong mga discoveries mo when you were doing Lav Diaz film?
I wasn't exactly the brightest student in Philippine history, no? So I feel like I want to call up my Philippine history teachers when I was in high school and say, pasada na ba with Hele, with Arbor, well, with Lav's take on Philippine history. I was able to really learn straight from Lav, who's also in a way, you know, a historian, a teacher of history. You know, he was able to answer a lot of my questions on, you know, Dr. Jose Rizal, his impact on our nation. You know, the characters of Isagani, and the curiosity that he brings to his character. For Simon, who was trying to really preserve the work of Dr. Jose Rizal and make sure that it was known, it really instilled in me the pride of being a Filipino. Also. We had such, you know, a brutal history. You know, we were colonized. We were always fighting for our freedom. And even to a certain extent today, we're still sort of fighting for our freedom. We're still searching for our identity. You know? But at least what this experience gave me was that at the end of the day, every day you shouldn't stop fighting for what you believe is right. You should always, you know, I don't want to say struggle, but you should always challenge yourself to continue to get better as an individual. And we should stop, you know, blaming people. I think for me, is sometimes the change begins with just you. And, you know, people are just finding people to blame, people to, you know, ganito, kasi traffic, kasi ganito. But let's also contribute our own. Imagine if all the 100 million Filipinos or plus contribute something good, we could easily prove. I think just like making a great film, you need a collaborative effort. I think just like a great country, you need to have everybody collaborate, you know, for the greater good. So that's kind of what, it's still patriotism in me and greater love for my country.
So the change can start from you.
From us. Dun sa 8-hour na film, alin sa mga eksena ang mas tumatak sa'yo?
There's a scene at the end of the film with Isagani, John Lloyd's character, and Nengi Cabrillo's character. I think it was in the trailer, and it was basically Isagani who's, for me, the character that kind of represents the youth today, at least for me, that's how I look at it, because he was always asking questions. Bakit ganito? Bakit ganito? There's a line, bakit kyo? Bakit ganito? Bakit ganito? That's what resonated in me, is because we're asking the same questions today also, diba? But it's like, why haven't we progressed, you know, from then till now? And it really hit me, and it made me realize that, you know, sometimes we should stop asking questions and start creating action, you know. And so yeah, that scene in the end really, really hit me. And I love the tikbalangs, the characters of the tikbalangs, yeah, the mythology part, and how Lav just weaved that into history, into literature. It was just really seamless, you know. Bernardo, Cherie Gil, and Angel Aquino played the mythology part of the film, and I really liked it.
Three actors in one character.
Yeah, but they represented different roles. But there was a scene there where they actually, it was one of the props that I asked the production designer, can I have that? It was the head of the horse, the tikbalang horse. So that's in my office now if you go there. So.
Direk Lab kasi mentioned that LTD is one of the greatest module for, like, if anyone wants to get into politics. Do you have also, do you share the same thoughts?
Well, you know, Lav's on another level in terms of when it comes to I just listen and observe what he says, and I think for me, naman, you know, at least for today's generation, it's it would be, unless, yeah, I guess it, in schools it's taught, naman. But it can't just be taught, it can't just be read, you know, there needs to be action. I mean, people sometimes just go through the motions of things. Okay, I read it. Okay, I'm inspired, and then you next day back to questioning, back to blaming them. There really needs to be a generation out there that will create action, an action that can create good. That's what we need, and hopefully this film ignites that, or at least sparks some sort of movement. And at least 10 years, 20 years down the line, I want a great Philippines. I'm sure that's what everybody wants. So we all have to start creating action, and. And learn from our history, of course.
Thank you.
Okay, thank you, Jude. And the last question will come from your name, please, and your black site, please.
Joe Pomo.
So, can you use the mic, please?
Hi, good afternoon. I'm Joe Pomo from New Media. Okay. So from the little that I've seen from the trailer, it seems like there was a lot of work and attention given to the lighting, to the framing. I'm just curious. Lab very particular when it comes to the technicalities.
Is he a lab person, actually?
You have to give a lot of credit also to Larry Manda, our cinematographer. I think him and Lab have this kind of unspoken rapport. And I would observe them, as a producer, I would observe them, and I'd always tell them, don't mind me, I'm invisible, you know? And they just had this, it's as if him, Lav, Larry Mann, and the camera were just one person. It just felt that way, and it was my first time to ever see a director and a cinematographer cry in the middle of a scene. I mean, at least for me, my experience. I mean, they were literally crying, and then, like, I was like, oh my god, did we cut this? I mean, it was just, you know, the scene was just so powerful. It just showed me how involved they were in the story. That every frame, the composition, the lighting, was not taken for granted. It was really, I could tell that Lav and Larry had this sort of expression, sort of theme that they wanted to use to tell the story. And believe me, when you watch this film, it's not just a beautiful story, it's also beautiful to look at. I remember one of my conversations with one of the jury, she's a photographer, she's Richard Duncombe, and that was one of the things that she mentioned, how beautifully it was shot. The cinematography was just breathtaking. Sometimes you don't even have to listen to what's going on, but you can already feel it in just the images alone. And that's just how powerful each image is. And, you know, yes, it's 8 hours, but it's 8 hours of beauty in every aspect. You know, and every aspect, from story to acting, to the cinematography, to the production design, to the producing, so, to the direction, to the writing. It's really a priceless effort of love for everyone, for Lav.
Okay, that's the last follow-up question. So this is being marketed as an 8-hour challenge. From your personal experience, how would you, what kind of tips or recommendations would you give the moviegoers that are eager to watch it on the 26th? How would they maximize the whole experience or digest the varying themes that are all melting in this film?
For me, first of all, is come with an open mind, come with an open heart, come ready to receive. And the film is there, ready to give, ready to shock, ready to affect. If you can open up your mind and open up your heart when you do watch Hele, there could be some crazy things going on there. I always say it's like Lav injected a drug in his film that it's going to affect you somehow. And so just come with an open heart, come with a mentality that's ready to be challenged, so that you can really appreciate the cinema of Lav Diaz. You know, give it a chance. Support one of the very humble, one of the very nice master storytellers that our country has produced. Let's support our own. And so I hope that's what people will have when they go watch the film. But of course, yes, it's 8 hours, so you know it's also a test of patience and endurance, so expect that. As much as possible, I know we're in a very cell phone technology, but stay captivated with the film. Sometimes maybe checking texts or messages is well, you can't avoid that, but it's sometimes it may take you out of the moment. It may take you out of the moment, you know, but you might lose it. And that's one of the reasons why in Berlin, people were able to appreciate cinema, is that the audience in Berlin actually, when they do have to make a call, they actually leave the cinema. Sometimes even the mere presence of a light in a dark cinema can ruin a viewer's experience. When we spoke to Miss Meryl Streep about it, you know, she mentioned that it changed every molecule in her body. That I remember talking to her at the dinner, and she said that you know, she prepared physically and mentally for the 8 hours. It was the first in her whole life. But she told me she had her shawl, you know, she had a cup of tea, she had some of her food, and she was ready for it. And it was nice to hear that. So I guess, yeah, embrace it. It's not every day you get a Lav Diaz cinema in, you know, 20 plus cinemas all over the country. So let's support Lav, let's support Hele, and let's be proud that this is purely Filipino made.
Thank you so much.
Okay, thank you for that question. And the last question will come from Oreo. Better be, relevant.
Direk, you as a director, are you willing to make a film like this?
I don't think I can. I'm actually shooting a film now, and it's just my style to shoot the way I shoot my films. I am definitely not going to replicate a Lav Diaz. I won't even try to do that. I think what I take from learning from Lav is I take into my sort of cinema. I think every filmmaker, every director wants to have their own voice. Yes, we are inspired by filmmakers, we're inspired by films. I know Tarantino keeps saying he steals from his movies, right? From other movies. But no, I don't think I could tell a story the way Lav tells it. You know, for me, my style is I need to move the camera, I need to engage it. That's just my style. And I'll just leave it to Lav with this kind of cinema. That's his expertise, and I won't try to replicate it at all.
How was it working with the cast, the crew, or with Direk Lav?
Oh, it was beautiful. We're like a family now. You're talking about separation anxiety. Actually, we up to this day, we still have our chat group, you know, there, and everybody once in a while checks in. How are you doing? You know, we share news about what we're doing and, of course, our other work. We really bonded in Sorsogon. We really bonded in Berlin. And it's one of those experiences that we will share together for the rest of our lives. And whether or not we get to work again in the future, we will always have Hele to look back on. I would work with any one of these people again. The actors, the crew, the staff, Lav. If there's an opportunity to produce for Lav again, yes. You know, there's an opportunity to work with all these wonderful actors in a heartbeat. Thank you.
Okay, thank you, Oreo. Direk, Judy's interested to find out, after our Berlinale, ano na po yung mga international film festivals na papasokin?
Well, yeah, actually, there are many invites already.
Confirmed.
I think Bianca would know more than me, but I know we're going to Hong Kong International Film Festival next week. That's going to have, after the Philippines, it will be Hong Kong. So the Philippines gets the Asian international premiere, and then Hong Kong gets it next in the Hong Kong International Film Festival. And I think it's going to Istanbul. I know it's going to some other countries in Europe. But we have invites. Actually, right now the challenge is scheduling it. You know, and hoping. I think from the film festivals alone, we're actually creating a lot of income already. So that's really helping. The festivals are very sensitive with announcements because sila. So I can say Hong Kong. I think Istanbul is one, but definitely, you know, Lav is a staple in a lot of small festivals too. So his presence will be felt there with Hele, especially now that it's stamped with a silver bear. You know? So.
Yeah, I know, guys. Thank you so much. Social media is so relevant and so important in today's society, and I appreciate stuff like this. And you know, whether or not you appreciate the film, thank you for the support that you give it. And I do hope you get affected. If you do watch on the 20th at the special screen or on the 26th, I hope it affects you in a positive way, and that you can continue to share the cinema of Lav Diaz, not just with Hele, but with his films from now on. So thank you again for your support. Maraming salamat.
Yehey!